bad. We were first.
Whiskey, and a 5-4 uniform, you can pull up, hold short, 209 monitor tower.
Copy that, 5-4 uniform going up, 04 uniform, sorry, going up, with monitor tower, thank you.
7-4 whiskey.
Hold on, 7-4 whiskey.
Tower Gulfstream 450 Hotel Quebec, looking for the visual 3 right.
Gulfstream 450 Hotel Quebec, Peach Tower, runway 3 right, clear to land.
Land 3 right, 450 Hotel Quebec.
Assess 5204 uniform, Peach Tree Tower, right turn out approved, runway 3 left, clear for takeoff.
Right turn out approved, runway 3 left, clear for takeoff, 5204 uniform. Back to it.
to stop at a certain altitude?
It's at 3,000.
3,000?
Yep.
Okay, very good. First time in Foggles.
Really? Wait, actually?
Yeah. We haven't done a ton of instrument anything.
Okay.
We did 180s like out of a cloud, but an unusual attitude, I just closed my eyes.
Oh. Oh well. Okay.
This is great.
Good to know.
It's a little spooky, but...
It is quite spooky.
I have my instruments.
You have your trust them. And at least you have a pilot who's visual right now.
Yeah.
So you haven't done constant rate climbs or constant speed climbs or anything?
No, not really.
Oh. That changes. Okay. Well, well, you did well. For one, being under the foggles, and two, never really having been told to do like a constant anything.
Yeah.
But, I mean, instrument is constant, instrument basic instrument maneuvers, constant speed climbs descents, and then constant rate climbs.
Gotcha.
And I mean, I can explain to you later why you practice that, but let's just continue on for now.
Okay.
I want you to climb at 70 knots back up to 3,500.
Alright. Let me get back to that heading, though.
Yep, 020. Things get kind of funky when you're under the foggles.
Yeah.
Alright, and just remember that before you do any big power changes or increases, you want to enrich in your mixture again.
That's true. Okay. Alrighty. 70 knots?
70 knots. I don't really care what your rate of climb is or anything. I really care about 70.
Okay.
And that's because an instrument, like ETA, is a cool thing. Like if you lose comps, ETA is something that people are going to expect you to like get somewhere by.
Yeah.
So obviously airspeeds are more important. Alright, 020 heading.
Controls. I got controls.
Alright, let's do back to 3,500. 180, so I'll have you turn to 360.
Perfect.
And actually, let's just say 3,600.
Okay.
And whenever you're ready, a 180-degree standard rate turn.
Okay.
But now that you know what you're looking for, I'll kind of explain what that all means.
Yeah. We're climbing a lot.
Yeah, we are.
Back down and back on the heading as well.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
There you go. The standard rate turn is the turn where you're doing 3 degrees per second.
Okay.
So in instruments, worst case scenario, right? You're a VFR pilot, you accidentally fly into clouds.
Yeah.
And for some reason you lost your heading. And
right.
Well, if you did, if you still had the rate of turn indicator, you did a standard rate turn for 1 minute,
yep,
you'd be at 180.
Yeah, Abby explained that to me.
Right.
That makes sense.
So that's what the standard rate turn's about.
Yes.
And usually what I'll do is I'll go out and I'll time my students, so I'll cover up their heading indicator, I'll just say, give me a standard rate turn, we're going to time it. And they're usually within like plus or minus 10 degrees of where they started, and I'll make them do like a full 360. If you guys ever have time, it's a really good exercise to do. Awesome.
360. Lost about 60 feet. Not bad.
Not bad. Okay. And I want you to close your eyes.
Okay.
And put your chin on your right shoulder.
Alright.
And give me a right turn.
Are you kidding me?
No, do it.
Alright.
Recover, I want you to open your eyes and recover from whatever unusual attitude you put yourself in.
Okay.
Alright, nose down. Recover. Good.
Yeah, back to power off just a little bit, but...
Awesome. Let's do that again, but put your chin on your left shoulder.
Okay.
Alright, let's do a left turn. That's a power. Alright, right turn.
Oh yeah, just a touch.
That's the whole point. That's why I make students do it themselves with their eyes closed.
Yeah, that was really good.
They can actually feel like what it feels like to not know what you're doing.
Yeah.
Do you need a second? You want me to take flight control?
No, I'm good.
Okay, good. Alright, that's all we gotta do with the foggles today. So I'll take flight controls.
You got controls. I'm gonna take this jacket off too if you wouldn't mind holding
I'm gonna turn us back to the north real quick.
Do it. That is the... Yeah, I was like, wait a minute, I'm a sport pilot, right? Did I just...
join an alternate universe where... doing instrument? That was fun.
No, that's just the basic instrument stuff.
Right,
in
if
case you get
in
a cloud.
Inadvertently, yeah.
Like, that's like lessons 1 through maybe 3 of actual instrument.
Right.
Alright, for sport pilots, what altitude do you have to be at for your stalls in slow flight?
The PTS that we were talking about said 1,000 feet.
Yep. Alright, you have flight controls?
I have flight controls.
1,000 feet? That's really uncomfy for me, so we're gonna go up to 4,000.
Yeah, it seemed low. Seemed low to me as well.
Yeah. So 4,000 with this 360 heading. you get to 4,000, I'll have you go into slow flight. And then slow flight's...
It's like a birthday balloon. Like a Mylar balloon.
Actually?
Yeah.
That's kind of crazy.
Wow. I was like, what is that? Oh my goodness.
When we get up to 4,000 feet, I'll have you do slow flight and do whatever pre-maneuver stuff you'd have to do for any kind of maneuver.
There we go. Drop the nose. Power. Power. It's also been about a month.
Right? Everything was great. You forgot one thing.
Yeah?
You never established your descent. We'll talk about it later.
Oh, right. Like an approach to landing stall, yeah. Yeah, I hadn't done it in the context of, like, an examiner in a while. Okay.
The ACS does say you should establish a descent for the maneuver, so, like, theoretically, I don't think anyone's ever going to fail somebody off of not establishing a descent, but it is something that's, like, a failable item.
Sure, okay.
So, remember, the FAA has published these maneuvers for, like, a scenario of flight. This is the landing scenario.
Landing scenario.
So they want you... When I say power off stall, decrease your power, or sorry, yeah, decrease your power, do like your approach speed, so like, I don't know, 60, something like that, and then say, all right, I'm establishing a descent. You can at least, if you at least say the words, and lose about 100 feet, and then go into it, I like, look outside, I'm like, all right, that's my field, I'm coming into descent, and now I'm going to pitch up for whatever reason.
Yeah, I think with Huntley, we did that, like, we picked a place to be the runway. And went through the whole landing thing.
Yep. So just remember, it's a really common thing to forget establishing your descent.
Got it.
But that is a part of the maneuver.
Yeah.
And if you open up the PTS, it will say that.
Yeah.
Just establish it, stabilize descent. All right. Power on stall when you're ready.
Okay, doke. So here, I'm going to slow down to about rotation speed.
Yep. Which gets really hard to get to 50.
Yeah.
So I will go, like, as long as we're below 60, or at least 60, I'm satisfied.
So we're gonna climb out at anyway, so power, right rudder, climbing out, on that cloud. There it is. Back control here, right rudder. Resume our climb. A more prudent angle.
Bingo level off. Right here. 41 is good. Yep. Overall, procedurally, your stalls are great. The only thing I have to say is, what? Oh, there are little wisping clouds over here. Let's point towards the lake.
Yeah, we're good.
When you're... You stall when you reach the critical angle of attack, right?
Uh-huh.
So no matter what, as long as you come down, you're good to go, right?
Yeah.
So I will usually pitch for the horizon.
Okay.
And not necessarily 10 degrees below the horizon.
Okay.
Because that could... Some examiners might see that as, like, going into a dive.
I see.
Which is also not great.
Yeah.
So I usually like to keep it between, like, negative 5 and 0 degrees.
And just break the stall. And, yeah. Okay.
Because as long as you're at the horizon, like, you're unstalled.
Yeah.
And then you add power to get back to, like, your energy.
Yeah, okay.
But yeah, other than that...
I like that, that makes sense.
Procedure-wise, you're good. Alright, well, looks like we have a fire on our right wing. What are we gonna do?
Oh, boy. We are gonna add a lot of rudder and right angle, and we're gonna slip it like this and get it away from the plane.
And let's increase our airspeed for airflow over the wing.
Yeah. And then we're gonna land.
Right. What could be causing that fire?
Are you? Okay.
Oh yeah, no, that's not.
I was trying to level up. Alright, we'll still do this.
Yeah, no, keep doing it.
An electrical, probably something with the light. An electrical fire with the light on the wing.
So what could we do?
We could kill all these lights.
Alright. Turn it back on because we need a
fire. We do need that, yes.
Alright, you can recover.
Okay. Cool, we put it out.
Alright, let's go towards the lake.
Yeah.
And let's do a turn around a point.
Alright.
You get to choose the point. Not to be picky about that.
Okay. Get down to 2,000. Or maybe slightly above. I've done one turnaround point to the left and one to the right.
In your entire life?
In my entire life.
Oh!
I did them for the first time the flight before last. Abby also was, there's a lot of things with Abby too, which is like, you haven't, huh? You haven't done that yet?
Interesting.
Huntley had a very unique sort of...
Huntley did. He did. Like, I would do Huntley's rental checkouts when he was, like, not a CFI.
Oh, yeah?
And when we flew, he's an excellent pilot. Like,
oh, yeah.
I was like, you're actually such a good pilot, makes me jealous. You are a bit odd, though, when it comes to how you like to fly the airplane.
Like, I think my fourth flight ever, we just went to Pickens and just did, like, seven touch and goes and just did landings all day.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
What now?
Okay, well, I'm gonna pitch for the best glide speed first.
Don't touch
it. 70, not touching it. Or please put my hand.
Now you have the urge for it.
Yep.
I would too.
And...
where are we gonna go?
My, that one over there. All roads have a lot of power lines, though, but
there's this huge highway right
interstate, or the highway there does look pretty good.
Alright.
I think that's our best option.
So, going northbound, it looks pretty empty. What I would do is I'd turn the plane southbound.
Yeah.
Land into the traffic, so the cars see you coming.
I got it.
So they can move out your way. And that's what I would do, right there. Alright, cool.
Yeah, we're looking good. Yeah, oh, there we go. Yeah, I would feel pretty good.
Yeah. And honestly, you would probably just want to like circle down, keep like doing like a semi-pattern around the highway.
Until you get
low enough.
Yeah, because there's these bridges.
Alright, that's power. Let's level off 2,300.
I have been doing a lot more of scanning, like as we go.
This is good.
I learned
for
that.
For emergency.
Well, yeah, because I got called out. Caught out. One too many times, being like, have you been looking? Like, oh, not really. All right.
Find a point, any point.
You can do that tiny little sandbar looking thing.
Okay. Maintain 2,300.
Like,
that's gonna gonna turn around to point. You might wanna come out a little bit.
Yeah, I was wondering if I was too, yeah, too close.
The good thing about the lake is there's tiny little points everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
Okay, this would be okay.
I kind of lost the point. I'm sure you still see it, yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay, I'm starting.
We're a bit close, but it's okay. Peninsula looking thing right there.
Got it.
I'm gonna turn around and point there.
Okay.
So, about 2,200. Now, sir, at some point in this turn, it's gonna feel like I'm not turning at all. Because I'm trying to counteract the wind. But, I'm looking out. I'm kind of climbing, but I'm mainly just looking out. Turning around the point. I'm getting pushed into it, so I'm gonna decrease my bank angle.
Yeah. Okay, so that is what I was doing.
Yes.
I would just bank less.
Pushed into it again, so I'm going to continue outwards. And now I'm going to push too far out, so I'm going to start banking heavy.
Got it.
Yeah? Visually it makes sense?
Yeah, I think that's what I was doing.
Good. Alright, you have light controls?
I have light controls.
Let's keep doing it around this peninsula.
Okay. I might start even a little earlier, I don't know, like,
I
just because if I start at 10 and then you can't get in, you eat up those miles quick.
Yeah.
Wind 0703.
Alright, let's be careful of the Dobbins airspace.
I see that, right there.
Yeah.
Copy, is flying over the King Queen building now.
November 4000 Charlie Rock. November 5204 uniform. Set your left turn inbound. Left down, runway 3 left. Report over the King and Queen.
Copy that. Left turn to left downwind for 3 left. Which no one over King and Queen. 0-4 uniform.
November 404 Delta, correction, Cherokee 6919 Julia, traffic you're following is a Cessna. About 2 miles west of you, joining the left downwind. We're at 2600 indicator, report him in sight.
Negative contact, we'll let you know when we have him in sight. 19 Julia.
Make sure.
Yeah.
November 11 Charlie Alpha, I didn't observe. That is a left downwind from runway 3 left. There's traffic 5 miles north of the field, Cessna, northbound 3200 indicator.
That's downwind for 3 left, traffic in sight, 11 Charlie Alpha.
November 84 Golf, that precinct on traffic.
Easy to see traffic. This time, that's nice.
Echo factor frequency change approved. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Can I just let them know that we're turning? At
Tower. Okay. Well, tell them that you're
traveling.
Number
100 Julia, Cessna to the Cherokee. You're, no, Cessna. You're following to the wide left downwind.
We got them in sight now. They're wide 100 Julia.
Number 404 Delta Charlie, runway 3 left to the lane. Runway 3 left to the lane, 04 Delta Charlie. November 6919 Julia, number 2, runway 3 left for touch and go.
Number 2, 3 left, clear for touch and go, 6919 Julia.
November 04, remember Bravo, P-Street Tower, fly straight out, runway 3 left, clear for takeoff.
Fly straight out, 3 left, clear for takeoff, touch and go, remember Bravo.
November 11 Charlie, after that, P-Street call, Cessna, pass off the left, no flag.
Alright, sir,
very good. Okay. November 6918 Hotel, extend up, when I'll call your cross.
Extend up, when you call my cross, on 6901 Hotel.
November 5204 uniform, Cherokee, you're following to the downwind of the tower.
Copy that, turn left here at the Cato Point, 0 for uniform.
November 6981 Hotel, the traffic is following to the side catch about 3 miles northwest of the field.
Do you like a 45?
Go downwind?
Look at the traffic, 6981
Hotel.
Sky Fox, please retire. Yes, sir, Charlie Pack, southwest departure.
Which is about here. Sky Fox, please retire,
Charlie Pack, clear for takeoff, southwest approved, maintain VFI to below 1,500. Altimeter 3042, I got 3 aircraft in the pattern.
Sky Fox, roger, 1.5 outbound southwest.
Cherokee 19 Julia, you said you did have the assessment, you're following the side?
Yep, we still got him in sight, 19 Julia.
Three. That's right.
Peachtree Tower.
Send 3042.
Oh, three, right? I missed that.
November 5204 uniform, Cessna about a mile off the departure end, it's going to be following you in the pattern.
Copy that, traffic inside, 04 uniform.
Cessna A10 Hotel, Skycatcher, you're following off your left and the downwind. You're good to turn cross if you haven't already.
There they go, cool.
We'll go ahead and turn across, I'm still looking out for that traffic, no.
It just got really bumpy.
November 11 Charlie, after your phone, assessment, about 2 miles off the departure and turning cross. So maintain 2,500 to get in the
right.
Maintaining 2,500, looking out for the traffic, 11 Charlie, office.
November 5204 uniform, Cherokee, your phone's in the downwind, approaching the base turn.
Copy that, looking, 0 for uniform.
Peachtree Tower, 619
right,
Golf,
Peachtree
Tower,
3 right.
Yeah,
number 619 Golf, Peachtree Tower, runway 3 right, clear to land.
Clear to land, 3 right for 619 Golf.
Probably just a lot of wake.
Hey, what hotel has downwind traffic,
sorry? Number 5204, uniform, your number 3, runway 3 left, clear to land.
Number 3, runway 3 left, clear to land. Clear to land, 0 for uniform.
Number 6981 Hotel, thank you.
I see the helicopter, yeah.
For 11 Charlie Alpha, that's just established the downwind in front of the edge of 12 o'clock in about a mile.
11 Charlie Alpha, traffic in sight.
Thank you.
Is that helicopter?
Is that the Cherokee talking about? On base? Yeah. He's on base, okay.
Yep, there's also that.
04 uniform, there's a helicopter heading to your left a little above. You're going southwest bound, restricted to 1.5 above.
Copy that, we just spotted him. Thank you very much. 04 uniform.
Yep, that's a Cherokee.
Alright, sweet.
November 704, River Bravo.
Alright, don't turn in until you're moving. We're closer.
Yeah. I'm gonna slow down.
Romeo Papa, Peachtree Tower, maintain 3,000, turn eastbound, make about a 5 mile right downwind for 3 right.
Alright, 3,000, and then turn eastbound, we'll make a 5 mile downwind, 3 right.
They're slightly slower than the Cherokees too, so.
Yeah, that's true.
November 619er Golf, Peachtree Tower, traffic on the left downwind, turning left base for the parallel runways, Skycatcher.
We're looking for him. He's inside, 619 Golf.
PG Tower, this is 404 Delta Charlie. Are we clear to go to ground?
4 Delta Charlie, contact ground.
Will do, thank you. 04 Delta Charlie.
Right there. Maybe like a mile or two away.
Yeah, there they go.
November A1 Hotel, your number 3, runway 3 left, clear touch and go.
I'm 33 left, clear touch and go, 6981 Hotel.
November 11 Charlie Alpha, your number 4, runway 3 left, clear to land.
Number 43 left, clear to land, 11 Charlie Alpha.
Yeah, that was, helicopters. Alright. Got guy taken.
Oh, Kenny Rockets.
Yeah.
Wind 0604.
Skyfox, thanks.
They're gonna get off the runway in time?
Skyfox, thanks. Good chance of first.
Skyfox, thank you.
Oh my god, I did not know you had parallel traffic.
Number 5, Romeo Papa, start your turn for the downwind.
Alright, starting our turn for the downwind.
There you are.
Yep.
5, Romeo Papa, altitude
right,
discretion.
Alright, taking off.
Alright, our discretion on the altitude, 5, Romeo Papa.
Alright, there's a tree right there. Watch
yep,
out.
Yep, I got it. Haven't come in this low before over here.
Yep.
Golf left turn at Juliet, contact ground.
November
05 uniform, left turn at Bravo, contact ground.
Left turn off at Bravo, contact ground. Appreciate you, 04 uniform.